multiple sclerosis, which is a fancy way of saying I have many scars. The scars that multiple sclerosis is talking about are not out the external ones, but they're inside. They're on my brain and they're on my spinal cord. And so what the scars do, it kind of like makes it where my brain can't talk to different parts of my body. And so far, it's always affected me from the waist down. But over the past, I don't know, probably 10 years now, it's been progressively getting, you know, down my arms, down my hands, or not even down my arms. It's like, for my hands, it started with my fingertips and then it's slowly moving up. And now it's like, I don't know, like right around here. But anyway, so the scars, like I used to, when I used to try to walk all the time, then as my scars, as multiple sclerosis, I have progressive form. And as it got worse, then I began to just not trust my legs. Like one time I was gardening and I got so hot and I didn't think I would make it back into the house. Like I was seriously, I had to crawl and then finally basically army crawl the very last part of the way because my legs just didn't work. The heat really affects people with multiple sclerosis. And so anyway, then, so now that it's affecting my hands, then it's weird. It's like I've already broken 2 jars of pickles, and now even my daughter was just helping me get the pickles out of the fridge and stuff and put them back in there because it's scary. I mean, seriously, cleaning up a jar full of pickles is not exactly fun, and plus, you know, we need pickles, and so anyway, it's hard. I can't like really open jars now, and I don't really trust, like I don't trust my hands, and that's what happened eventually with my legs. Like I tried using walker. I mean, eventually at first I kept trying to walk, and then finally I fell down like numerous times. Finally, I started using a walker, and then I would occasionally use a wheelchair, but I would still fall down all the time, and then I fell and broke my hip, and after that, I still, like, tried to walk for a while, and then I realized walking is overrated, and so I stopped trying, and so now my legs have atrophied a lot more, which means, you know, they got, like, they shrunk. The muscle tone has started to, but I still get a lot of spasms and stuff, and that keeps my muscles really strong, I think, and keeps, like, me having some meat on the bones. But, anyway, now I can't really trust my hands, and so my body, like, that's another thing I was thinking about, like, even my bladder and my bowels, it's like, my brain, I mean, you are not your body. I am not my body, and there has been, multiple sclerosis has been, like, a very important thing that's helped me realize that, that, like, sometimes, like, even just a little, when I was using the restroom, then I was trying to feel, because I can't feel a lot of stuff on my legs. I can, it's weird because I can feel like touches like this. I can, I mean, certain spots, but I mean, some spots are completely numb and stuff. It just, it's weird. It's hard to tell. And now that my fingers are so numb too, it's hard to know what I feel with them either. But I feel a lot of stuff. Anyway, though, yeah, so, like, even when I use the restroom, like, if I pee in the toilet, then I'm like, woohoo, bladder, great job, you did great, because, I am not my bladder, and I am not my bowels. Like, if I feel it in my stomach or whatever, if I don't have to take a laxative or manually, like, if I don't have to do anything and it just works, then I'm like, good job, bowels, good job, bladder. Because I have realized that I'm not in control of so much. Like, I mean, you think that, I mean, everybody knows they're just automated and stuff, but then it's so much better if you make friends with your body parts and if you recognize, okay, well, maybe I can't trust my fingers, but I can trust, like, my bowels, maybe not all the time. So, and same with my bladder, they still have MS too, but I mean, it's helpful to work with your body, even though, you know, we're all in this thing together. But anyway, I don't even know what my point with going off on that was. I think my main point of making this video that, yeah, like, multiple sclerosis, now it's making it where I can't, you know, open jars and I can't trust my hands to hold something. Like, it'll just drop, you know, or they can't actually keep the pressure, you know. And so that's what I'm dealing with now. But even no matter what you're dealing with in your life, then hopefully you just take it as it comes. Because, I mean, there's so many things out there, and I don't like comparing anyone's or saying mine is better or yours is worse or whatever. Like, yours is better, like, sorry. Anyway, it's not about, like, what's the issue. It's about you working with your body and just trying to take every step as it comes, and hopefully you are making the best of your life, no matter what life has given you. And I'm going to make the most of my life, no matter what happens either. And today I'm feeling good, tomorrow I might be bawling, who knows. But the point is, we have to take each day as it comes, and we just have to just roll with the punches. Alright, I'm gonna stop this.